Whoa, everybody, this is me, John Paul Kersey, and welcome to my channel. Anyways, I'm here to talk about two wicked, wicked products. Well, one mainly, and the other one just kind of goes with it. But anyways, first off, I'm going to talk about the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Is it the best photography phone that's out there? To me, it is, and it works with my workflow, and here's why. The first topic. The main point of why the iPhone 12 Pro Max works for me is because not only does it shoot raw when you do photos, now seeing how with all the updates and stuff, but also you can, the dynamic range is almost as good as the Canon EOS R5, is what I've read in articles. I don't know that for 100%, but I've heard it. And to be honest, when it comes to the editing bay, I could personally see how, maybe not as good as the R5, but how the dynamic range is mind-blowing. It's better than my 80D, and I know that for a fact. And the picture and the quality with the AI simulation that's going in on the sensor when it captures an image is phenomenal. And I absolutely love it. And the fact that it shoots raw, obviously it does time lapse. Obviously it does everything that every single other phone does, and it does it well. But the main thing that I like as someone that's a creative and comes out with concepts on my phone, the reason why I got a phone that can shoot real good image, because I have the LG Velvet 5G. It's okay. It's pretty good. For a mid-tier phone, it is actually amazing for the things that it can do for the value. I would say LG Velvet, amazing bang for buck, plus it's an awesome phone. I use that sometimes. I use it kind of like a backup phone for business, if you catch my drift. But anyways, the main thing I use this for is when I'm out at restaurants, or I'm at home and wifey about cook me a good meal, or I'm at home and Mother Dearest cooks me something that is forever cherished from generation to generation, then I pull up my phone, quick of a button, you know, put on the 12 megapixel camera, and capture the image. And yes, it's only 12 megapixels, but with the pixel shifting and with everything that's happening behind the sensor to enhance the image quality, it makes up like, man, like I said, it's literally the dynamic range and the quality that comes right out of this without even having to edit is just as good as my 80D, if not better. Yes, this is a phone, so you could easily pull out and capture images like that are mind-blowingly good as long as you know how to edit. You see, any image is good right off the hop. You can make an image good strictly out of a DSLR or a mirrorless or even a phone if you have good lighting. But when it comes down to the aspect of basically being able to capture a good picture on your phone and be able to see the quality that comes out is good. And that's what makes people think, okay, this is a good phone. But to be honest, the reality of it is that the phone is only as good as you let it be. And so is every other device, whether mirrorless or DSLR or any type of photography product, because I'm a photographer and I do photography stuff on the daily. Sometimes I take a break, sometimes I don't. But anyways, what pushes this further past just the phone is the ability to make the image quality what you want out of it when it comes to the editing bay, whether it be Lightroom Mobile, Lightroom Classic. You know, there's a bunch of other programs that are phenomenal when it comes down to the quality of the editing. You know, you could use GIMP. There's so many editing programs. But the basically is, do you know how to use your editor? It's one thing having a program, and another thing not doing enough research to be able to pull out flawless pictures with this. And back, like I said, this is what makes this phone better, is the ability to edit and make this a wicked editing phone. Because even in video, I threw it in DaVinci Resolve, threw on a couple quick color grade, and it was phenomenal. I was like, what? I was like, this came out of my phone! You know what I'm saying? And that blew my mind. But in all honesty, the ability to push the quality on the photo is sick. Like, you can do so much. You can really edit out of the raw files, and it's phenomenal. And I would recommend this 10 out of 10 to anybody that wants to take their phone mobile photography to the next level, if you catch my drift. Because the editing possibilities is what makes this phone a unique individual. Comparing it to the LG Classic was a phone that did a lot of stuff really good. It was kind of like the ADD of the phones. But now, this is kind of like a revolutionized Canon EOS R. This is basically my C-Cam. Pull it up, you know, pull out the C-Cam and take pictures of food, post them up real quickly, and you could be a pro food photographer in no time with the proper lighting. And if you had a couple MC-11s from Aperture, pull those out, you know, do nice lighting. Literally, that's all I do. I pull the MC-11s out, do some nice lighting, bam, bada boom, bada bang, you got a nice shot. So basically, this phone is phenomenal when it comes to the editing bay. Yes, it takes a good picture, and so does every other phone that's anywhere between 10 to, you know, 100 megapixels, like I've heard in rumored legends. You know, there is phones that are awesome. Megapixels only go so far, and I find even with a higher megapixel phone, because like I said, I've had a 48 megapixel phone, you crop in, it still looks like a cropped in image on a phone. It's not, I don't care, the megapixels are almost irrelevant when it comes to the ability. It's the dynamic range. It's the ability to push the post-processing. Because a photo is a photo if you snap it. That photo turns to a snap and then you have it. But then if you post-process the rabbit, you go down the rabbit hole like a habit. You know what I'm saying? And then it's just awesome. And that's when photography gets stepped up to the next level, is through post-editing and post-processing. Yes, you can be a person that's like 35 millimeter film and go out and take that picture and, you know, go into your red room or your dark room and just chill and relax. But, you know, with 2021 on the spectrum and the tech is about to blossom, this phone is epic, and I can't wait to see what the next iterations to come of the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Because the iPhone 12 Pro Max is the best photography phone. In my opinion, you can take it with a grain of salt. But to me, to be able to post-process a picture out of a phone sensor is phenomenal. And that's what I really wanted out of a phone, is to get up, close capture that moment, go home, edit it very quickly, because I got tons of presets that I'm making right now. And I throw in a preset, edit it of my own presets, and I do some wicked photos. So to me, photography through the iPhone 12 Pro Max is worth every penny, and it's basically, you can get amazing quality out of it, and it's absolutely phenomenal. So to be honest, would I recommend it? 10 out of 10. Would I give it to my kid? 10 out of 10. Would I make people happy with the quality of pictures that I get from it? Yes. You're not gonna be a pro photographer if you just go out and shoot photos with this for a living. It's not gonna look the same as like a Canon EOS R that's, you know, double the price of this. But when it comes to the quality of the image at the quick whim of your fingertips and the ability to post-process better than any APS-C mirrorless camera, to me is mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. So basically, I just hope that, you know, this helps you out with your image editing programs. And there's a lot of wicked phone photographers out there that would do phenomenal things with this. And the photography part, I'm pretty sure the iPhone 12 Pro, the iPhone 12, the iPhone Mini all produce phenomenal results that can edit very dramatically in the editing bay. The iPhone 12 series is beautiful, and I'm just so, so excited to see what is going to happen in the future with the next iterations to come. So stay tuned, because I'm going to show some B-roll of this iPhone 12 Pro Max, and I'm going to basically show what it's like when this phone is in someone's hands that know how to do with it, with the food photography that I demonstrated, quick setup, like 10 minutes, demonstrate up a quick setup, throw on some MC-11s, take the picture, and snap, 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 you get wicked photos. So to me, it is worth every penny to be able to have the dynamic range of this phone. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this episode of the iPhone 12 Pro Max, and I hope you have a wonderful day, night, and evening. Boys and girls, ladies and gents, I will be back soon. Ciao. Peace.